different from that perspective. You are asking a question from individual perspective about the universe. Okay, then you are asking, then you are saying I can't do anything because again you are coming at individual. That switching cannot happen. Once you become the universal, universal. At that point of time, what is the appropriate action? You'll know exactly. And you'll do. Then you'll not look at from right and good and bad from society point of view. You'll look at from right and wrong from the universal point, dharma and adharma from the universal point of view. Then what is possible or is impossible also you'll understand. And what is required to be, you'll also understand. So you'll do appropriately. Okay, say for example, I am teaching you people Vedanta. What qualification do I have? I have nothing. I am not a monk. I am not a scholar. I am teaching you. Because I know this is the right thing to do. Okay? So it's not, I am an engineer, a software professional. For teaching Vedanta, I don't have any qualification from any point of view. But I am doing it because I know this is the right thing to do. I am not doing it because you people come and appreciate me. I know this is the right thing to do and I know I see so many wrong understanding in the society. That's why I think this is the right thing to do. So I am not doing it for appreciation or I am not gaining popularity, nothing. Neither I am doing it as a time pass. I am doing it simply because it's the right thing to do. As an individual point of view, it's nothing, it's not right. I am a householder, okay? I left my job to focus on this. So it's not right thing. It's not right from the society point of view. It's wrong. It's not right from the spiritual. So some monks will say, what this guy will teach? He doesn't, does he know Vedanta? How many years he has studied? Not right and wrong. But I know what is right and wrong. Intuitively. So that perspective from the society, that perspective from the religion, it will collapse. Then universal right and wrong emerges, which is called dharma and adharma. So from that point of view, no, I may say that I want to change the world and go and start this thing, some dharma yuddha in the street. No, I won't do that. I'll see what is the appropriate thing, what way, best way it can be done. That's all. Like that, a right sense will prevail, right understanding will prevail. So you cannot switch between these two ideas, as an individual, as a universal. Then you ask a question from individual point of view, you can answer give individual point of view. If you ask a question from individual point of view and then go to see, ask what is called universal point of view, you can't guess the answer. You have to become that. It is like, my dear, every father you don't know will advise his son, my dear son, don't get married, okay? It is trouble. You know what son says? Papa, it's your experience. I want to know what marriage after getting married. Like that. You become universal, then you know the answer. My answer will not give you complete answer.
Yeah. You struggle to become, once you become, you know. Once you are, you know, you can become actually.
But the cooking and the baking will allow you to.
After your profession, you are never uncooked.
That's true. We have to come to that point to realize.
Who is that we? Who is that I? Again, you assume something. This assumption is also part of the perception.
So finally, just negate all concepts and just be in that sound.
All concepts are perceptions. All concepts are perception. Illusions. Okay? Then no concept is you. After no concept, then you become all concepts.
That's
the tricky part, because many of Vedantic teachings stop at that point.